Yeah, I know we're going to get a mod for this gun, but I'm not gonna take the gun out because that takes two slots. It's a big gun. ZOH. Still dead. I don't like these doors opening as well without my permission. So we need these. We're gonna get this. There was a knife in the other room. We can go back and get it. I don't know if I'm gonna bother coming back. I think there is a pouch in here when you come back with the electric transistor thing. Three knives now. Something's getting stabbed, that's for sure. Yeah. So I got all my weapons. I don't know, man. Leather jackets are cool. Leather jackets are really cool. I wish I had more money to buy more leather jackets, because it's actually like, I wear them all the time. I don't care if it makes me look like an old man. Like, you know, I just wear them all the time, and everyone's like, yeah, you know, he's gonna wear them. Like, he's that kind of guy. Ow. Just taking this out just to do this, really. Now it looks even worse. Like, it's much more powerful now, but like, I should take it, but like, you see I've got a lot of limited space right now, so, we'll take it out when we've run out of this, and then, you know, start, honestly, unless I get some high-powered rounds in the next room, I will put this gun away, the revolver. Righty right, so we can move on now. And save it though. Wait. Going back. Where am I going back? Not this way, it's this way now.
Antiviral agents in the west area.
So guess where we're not going first? Because game. Wouldn't it be nice for once if they were like, yeah, just go straight to the west area. You know, in one of these games where it's like, there's a clearly marked other area, and they're just like, nice. See that there's a level 4 clearance here. Guess what?
Senior staff clearance required for bridge access.
So go get the senior staff thing in this other area. Yeah, I wish I had more money for leather jackets. No. I've been looking at Lewis Leathers for a while. Lewis Leathers are awesome. I've seen them actually for sale over in China in some places. But only at like motorcycling shops, which are, and they're really expensive. They're always going to be expensive. They're the guys, they've got an outlet store in basically London near Oxford Street or Soho, and that's basically it. And they got, these guys are like vintage motorcycling guys, but they've outfitted like Lemmy from Motorhead, Motley Crue, the Ramones, Duff McKagan and Slash, I think, and they do some sick gear, but £300 to £450 for a belt, and thousands for the jackets. I'm like, they look so cool. It's just I don't have that. Well, I, you know, like everyone has, well, not everyone, but like everyone has, like, could save up £300, but I'm sure as shit not going to be spending that £300 on a fucking belt. You know what I mean? Because it is a bit like, yeah, come on, dude. Like, you know, that's a lot of money. Maybe when I'm inexplicably rich in the future, you know? Got a lot of handgun bullets now. I just saved it, but I'm going to save it again because I'm paranoid now. Yeah. I wish, you know. Maybe one day. I don't know when. So you can see he has the... Can we go through here? We cannot. There's nothing else here. You can see he has the thing.
Oh, God. That's terrible.
It's not much worse than anything else we've seen. So you can only read this on the way out.
Senior staff clearance required for computer access.
And it basically just says, yo. Ooh. Oh, that actually got me. Yeah, this is the area. The flame rounds area. These guys. Series of bugs that, like, the, what they call the guys that go in the RE4, the, I want to say eliminators, they're not eliminators. They're the ones that you have to snipe with the scope. They have those, but you can see them with the naked eye, and they're buds. But it's just like, don't even try, man. It's just easier just to shoot them with fire. Dispensing solution now. Do enough damage to them to kill them anyway. Because they're plants, right? So just set fire to them. If they grab you and you don't have a sub weapon, they can one hit you. It's just. Oh, it's. I've got too much. I used to have the thing. The cheat. I could just unlock everything now. Unlock both these places now, but we're gonna actually have to play the video game. Oh no, I know, right? So you can see the dispersal cartridge is here. And I'm an idiot. Again. Carrying, like, everything with me. When did I even pick this up? I can go back, but I have to deal with, he's burnt. Do you remember the other guy that I saw before that was hanging up there? It was like, whoa, 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 whoa. But I need this. What else is in this area? Just that.
Seriously?
He's up there. Get why it's getting so weird and like, get it. It's making me nervous. I don't like that area because it's always tense. Tense music is always playing. So yeah, I'm just, need this. Here I am. So, yeah. I have to go through there again now. I'm probably gonna fuck it up now. Theme of tension begins.
Oh,
do is now just stop it from being a problem. You may get up again. Nothing else in this area. I can hear more. Oh. You didn't die? I feel like there's a few that keep dropping in this area. The vines hanging from the ceiling, when you see these big vines, they just seem to just keep spawning more of them, so that's the problem. Yeah, we need the codes for these, you gotta memorize them. One of them's on the bottom of something, so you can take it with you, but it's just like the... Yeah. This area is like an infinite plant zombie area, so just, yeah, don't waste your time going through this area thinking, I'm gonna be fine, I'll just, like, kill everything. You won't. They keep dropping. Oh, yeah. That'll be fun. You can see that there, it gives you a hint of what the thing is, but it doesn't tell you everything. He has a grenade. That does nothing. The big gunpowder. Well, we'll be coming back, so it's not too big of a problem if I leave something. Dealing with these guys. Not one bit. Because they're everywhere. I can't see for shit because I'm fucking blind. Yay. Okay. I'm trying to remember that. I think I remember it, so I can just brute force it because I remember enough of it. Yeah. So that unlocks that area. You can't unlock the next area without either brute forcing, cheat sheeting, or just going around and finding the thing. Next area is a problem. Doing a lot of shiz. See, there's a guy standing up there in the corner. There's just a lot of them, and they just fall down. Best option is just to take the fucking get out. Not waste time in this area, just fuck around, just eat. We got a map. We got a gunpowder. I'm still surviving. I'm actually surprised, but like, we're gonna come across standard zombies now. And when there's standard zombies, there's very obvious we're making it difficult for you now, sliders in play, so. Unless I'm pretty good at fighting them, shit's gonna go sideways really quickly. So we need to get in here, but the power's out, so you can't get in. That's the save area. Here you can see all of these guys seem pretty dead, right? They seem pretty dead. Until you go and activate that thing, and then they come alive, then a bunch of lickers come alive, and then your life is just over. So, like, one of my friends was like, oh yeah, just grenade them straight away, and I'm like, I don't think I have it. Ooh, I do have a grenade. Ugh. see, like, oh, I've got an Chivo. And that basically just meant that they ain't getting up now. Or most of them won't get up as quickly. I think it's either you take this trophy or you fuck with this and turn all the power back on and they're like, sup! And you're like, oh, hello. This is a key item. Why, you say? Because someone, some hyper genius, thought it would be a good idea to put the thing on the bottom. Save you trying to memorize it, I guess. Wait. Have I been doing this for a long time? I have, haven't I? There. Oh, there's two of you. How did I forget that? Talk about RKO, man. Fuck you. You dead? Or we round two in on this? Now we're gonna go through here and some zombies are gonna be on the other side just waiting. Because they're little fucks like that. Every time, man. Every door. Not this door, this door. And if not that door, the next door. Because the asshole. They're blah, see? Fucking zombie. He was waiting. Yeah, because, you know, someone just got bit in the stairwell. Wow. He hasn't got any hands to grab. What's he gonna do? That's how not to play this game. Can't get up if I cut off your legs. No limbs for you. Oh man. I was talking about style switching earlier, wasn't I, with all of this, these guns. You ever think to yourself, oh man, if I was a video game or anime pro tag and I had style switching like Dante or... what my styles would be, and what they would entail, and what they would be based off of.
Son of a bitch.
So cool. Oh yeah, that'd be quite fun. It's like that kind of argument you have with anime guys who are just like, oh yeah, what would your stand be if they were like JoJo? And it's like, wow. Why is it with people taking knives to the face and not really caring? Look at this guy. So every time I put a knife through a guy's neck, they just decide that they're gonna survive it real chill like. It's like, dude, that's gonna fuck up your breathing. I don't care if you're a zombie or not, I think you still need your lungs a little bit. Or maybe you don't. Anything here? No? It says it's red. So there are guys.
What the fuck? Seriously? Damn it.
Shoot you in your horrible pants, your horrible chinos. Haha. I ruined your socks and sandals. Be it for me to judge. More gunpowder. I'm so glad I picked up those last ones. Oh, yeah, okay. See? You needed this. this signal modulator. So like I was saying, what was I saying? Somebody's note. Use the fire, burn them all. Literally what I was saying earlier. Yeah. You know those kind of conversations you have where it's kind of nerdy, but you kind of think, you know, if I was in a like video game like Dante, what would my style be? Or like if I was like in Yakuza and I was Kazuma Kiryu. And I'm like, oh yeah, no, it would be cool kind of thing if you could like work it out. But it's like, you know, it feels dorky talking about it, but you're like, wouldn't it be funny? And you're like, God, I'm such a loser. Okay. Now you're also like that, thinking like, well, did this have a point? And it's like, oh, you know, I thought it'd just be funny. You could have like different fighting styles based off of genres of music. So you could have something like punk rock and then like death metal and like have different styles based off of that. And somehow they would entail different. But it's like, how would that correspond to any form of martial art or, like, weapon type? And it wouldn't. And I was just like, lol, 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 lol. Anyway. What was the... See? These guys are...
What the fuck?
If that's the same one, they clearly don't die from fire. Maybe they take two. And just resurrect. Now you're all wondering what my stand name would be. I assume it's this way and not the other way. I fucked it up now. I've already forgotten. It's wrong. I know it's wrong, but I can't remember what's right. This is worse than fat one. Fat one at the end. Short. Top heavy and fat. Now we can do the horrible, horrible puzzle. Anywho, we got this, right? We got this. I can discard this. I have a trophy. If you're wondering what my stand was, I thought about it for all of, like, a couple of seconds, and I would, like, came up with a few name ideas, and then I was like, but a stand with this power exists already. It's basically Purple Hades, thing. Because I've mentioned before, I really like poison with one. Ooh, they go fast. They go fast when they're like. When they want to go fast, they go fast. Because, like I said before, I like poison Pokemon. And, like, for a long period of time, I was very interested in studying poisons and stuff. I would, like, wiki stuff and just find out, like, all of the plants and animals that were venomous or poisonous or had a similar kind of, like, toxic agent to them and just find out how it worked and like why it was different and why it was developed and like if it's a defense mechanism and like all of that shit and was really into it for a while and then I just kind of was like, oh, you know, like
manual mode engaged. Adjust amount of solution to match cartridge capacity.
So you gotta get that red circle. great. Small green tone. Greenness. No, this is bad green tone. See, this is wrong, right? I'm gonna do this. It's all in one. Yeah, I don't like this. Can you tell? This will do nothing. What am I doing? Will also do nothing. What am I doing? Oh, I know. No, I don't. Yes, I do. No, I don't. What am I doing? This is wrong. No, I want them all in this tube. The big tube. The big tube. Big tube. Medium tube. It's the summation of these two. Maybe. No. No. This is a bad puzzle. By which I mean it makes me use my brain, and I don't like that. So these are equal. Yes. This is what I wanted. I don't get it. Did it? Now it's all in this one. You know what I meant. Then we have very I think we've mixed these two, but I just split these two, so it can't be that one. It's gotta be this one, right? It's gotta be this. Yeah. Ooh. I did it with my brain. Big brain time. Got the cartridge. Good, good, good. Sorry. I was super professionally checking my phone. I was just expecting like someone from work to be bothering me, because they tend to do that all of the time. That's why I'm looking for another job. Get pissy when I'm like, hey man, it's the weekend, and it's like, what's that mean? It's like, leave me the fuck alone. Like, you know, like, they don't seem to get that. Like, yeah, let's not talk about work, not while I still work at the place. Where is the bastard? Tell me, we can work through this together. Gritting my teeth. You. I saw you, Z, fighting with the floor. You're so crispy. Fine, whatever. Tense, man. Fucking tension. Yeah, what was I saying? No. We're done going back up in the bad touch room. this up now. Yeah, let's fill our inventory with shit we don't need. There we go. Yeah, that's some shit we don't need. Yeah. Feeling good about all this shit. Oh man, I'm trivializing capitalism today, apparently. Look at all the shit I don't need. Yeah, well worth. Well, as we have shit we don't need, why not, let's say, kill anything else that's gonna fuck with me. See, I grenaded a lot of these fucks. I don't think they're getting back up, you know. Ooh, but you never know, these guys look pretty inert, but like, he jiggled. They act differently, their claws don't flop out this way. Wish I could throw rocks at things, just to see. It would have moved it, they make like hissing noises and shit. So we need Murph. Murph? Oos. Oos. No, how do I do? Murph. Oz. Murph. And Murph. You have to change the sine waves. Turns on the light. Don't turn off the light. Hear the subtle change in music, maybe the audio didn't pick it up. So this is the save room, that's the quest room. Quest room. Honestly, a lot of this game can be brought right down into, you're doing a lot of fetch questing. But that feels like it's a bit mean for the game. You know, sometimes when you're playing them, if you play the campaigns back to back to back, you're like, oh, I have to go do this now. I need to stab one more fool, or I can just leave the broken stabber in here, get a new stabber. Bye bye. Oh, that's fine, I'll just shoot an acid round in somebody's face later. Yeah, it's not enough that you got the solution, you've got to freeze the solution, otherwise it will cry. So we can get a knife. Lucky everyone had all of these exactly the same knives out. And these are like serrated carbon steel fingers, so it's hardly like, you know, oh, this lab needs these. Like, it's not like it's a scalpel or something more fitting. Okay, that's safe. After that last incident where I lost a load of content, loads of progress, I mean. I'm nervous about ever not saving. I was trying to be ballsy for the LP and it blew up in my face. So what were you talking about? Stand powers. I always thought I'd have something like toxicity or like toxic holocaust or something like that, and it would literally just be like disperses wide ranging, but as Green Day and Purple Haze both actually exist. This guy's gonna fuck with me, I can feel it. It's too weird the way he laid down there. They died in a very weird way. So this is where we gotta go. Am I missing something? Is there something on these desks? Like lore or something? Some insight? Yep. Okay, it's good to check. Yeah. Leather jackets, man. I could just talk about a whole episode as just leather jackets. She does come active.
Welcome back, Dr. Lee. You have 5 new messages.
So this guy is like, can you believe Cartwright? Cool your jets, asshole. Da da da. My boss sucks. We all know what that is. I put the secret on the bottom. We can make a little meeting. So that just goes in to get the pushes. So this is basically some, oh, that's your boss saying, huh, so too busy just, you know, taking a nap, bitch. And he's like, are you alive? Which is something that I say to my friends whenever they don't talk to me for a long period of time, because they're busy. I'm like, I hope you're not dead. We're under attack. People are dead. Can't operate the bridge with the wristbands we have here. Where is that buff? Okay, please reply. Plan 43 is going wild. I love this. House of the Dead does this as well, I'm pretty sure, where it calls one of its things, like, something 40, some plant number something. Although, no, it does a lot of tarot card stuff, which is pretty sick as well, very grindhouse. The sun, death, things like that, and you're just like, oh, that's pretty cool. Sloth. No, the fool is the giant sloth, I love that, with a human face, it's so weird. Remember Susie, the cheerleader? We were both into her. She wasn't into nerds. I still have to give you the bag those comics and games I borrowed, but you might have to wait a while. Cause I's dead, but I had a long enough chance to write a full email about a cheerleader I perved on. He was not into nerds like me, more into jocks. Whatever. I will never understand.
Damn. Should have packed my parka.
Hey man, I heard those leather jackets really retain heat. Yeah, that's good ambient work though, where she's actually shivering and shit. That's okay, fair enough. I'm gonna stop being a dick for a second. Thankfully, this is not another puzzle. You just shove it in and it comes out. Shove it in, shove it in.
Cooling sequence in progress.
Why does it gotta be that one? There was one time I was in chemistry in college, and we were doing something where we had, like, glass orbs, like, glass orb beakers, and we were doing something that would cause, like, an explosion of fire reaction, and one guy didn't know that was still happening because he wasn't paying attention.
Cooling complete.
And he set fire to something, and he literally had a flaming orb in his hands that was not very hot, but he decided the right response would be to go, oh, shit, and just throw it across the room, literally just yeet it across the room. And, yeah, everyone was laughing at him for a while about that. The other funny thing actually that happened in chemistry class is our chemistry teacher got pissed at us and started shouting at us, saying that we're not paying attention. And we're getting sick of this guy, and there was an obvious stoner. Like, the obvious stoner was so obvious, we just knew he was the stoner, right? This lady may become active. Alrighty. Yeah, and like he used to go to the bathroom for like most of the class and come back high and stinking a weed. And like he wasn't the only one in our class. There's a lot of guys that they kind of, you know, they looked the part as well, and they came in stoned out of their minds. So it's like, I don't want to be like some like boomer ass motherfucker going, oh, yeah, you know the kinds, the ones that have the longboards and the board shorts. Like, you know, guys on the forearm tattoos, you can't trust them. It's like, geez, like, man, like, you're basically describing me. Like, you know. Nah, it was, there was quite a few guys that were all hanging out, same kind of guys. Real fucking weird, like, dudes. And, like, they weren't chill stoners, they were, like, weird-ass motherfucking strange-ass stoners. One of them was a racist-ass stoner, so he'd come in, like, bonged out of his mind. Then he'd come in and sit next... Oh, acid. I was gonna say, I'm sure that does a lot, because it's really a powerful against living thing. You're living. Plants live. Well, if he's not dead, he is some Wicker Man motherfucker if he's not dead. Anyway, like, yeah, there was this one racist-ass guy, and he used to sit next to this Sikh dude who I actually think went to my secondary school as well. And he used to just be like, man, why are you so fucking brown? And be really racist to him and just say dumbass shit when he was high, and we'd just be sat there like, ugh. And the guy would just be brushing it off like, dude, I'm here to learn. I was just, like, really trying to not speak to this guy because he was cunt when he was, like, high as fuck. And this other guy, though, sitting around, I'll tell the funny story, not the dark story, about racism plaguing virtually everywhere you go. We'll talk about the story that's hilarious drug-related shenanigans. This chemistry teacher, she's kind of cute, kind of young, short little blonde thing, but she went absolutely nuts at us one time because none of us were paying attention and we all failed the test, and it was like, I used to get secondhand high with my friend, who was also the drummer of my thrash metal band, just by being around all of these stoners, and we were just giggling, and one time I literally had a baby bell on me, we were coming out of the thing for lunch, and I opened the baby bell, and you know when you take the red strip and then you try and, like, break it apart, and that doesn't work, and the cheese just snaps inside because it's too soft, it's been at room temperature for too long for baby bells, and it's just, like, two halves. I was just sat there, and I just said, fuck. This is why cops shoot innocent civilians in America. And he just lost it, and we were just sat there giggling, like, only two people who have been secondhand breathing in a fuck ton of pot can find that funny. It was kind of funny, but we were just sat there giggling until, like, literally, we were, and, like, anyway, this, I keep taking a tangent because this just opens a mine in my brain. So this guy comes in, stoned off of his mind, and she's, like, proper trying to, like, maintain an angry facade to try and, like, you guys need to buckle down, let's get ready. He comes in with a big grin on his face, sits down, looks at her with a grin on his face, and then just puts a book on his head, like, with this big fucking goofy grin on his face, and he's a big lanky motherfucker. He sat there, like, hunched over, his head and like halfway close to his shoulders like this, and he's just, like, grinning up. And she's just, like, looking at him, and you can see that she's cracking. She's trying to be angry. Shut up! And I'm just like, yeah, he's just ruined everything. You know, like... Yeah, that was, like, my college, man, everybody was stoned. Everybody except my friends, and most of my friends had the kind of level of munchies where you're like, these guys are stoned. Like, you know. Did I actually hit these guys enough that they aren't respawning? That's rare. Normally I just peace out through this area.